But so far, sir, Taraknath Palit and Sir Rashbehary Ghosh are concerned, the former breathed his last in the year 1914 and the latter died in the year 1921. Yet, in 2019, we are commemorating the lives and works of these two great sons of Bengal, precisely because of two reasons. First, that these fought like giants in the society. And second, great men are rare. Now, Sir Taraknath Palit was born, as has been said by my learned speakers, with a silver spoon in his mouth. Yet, he dedicated his entire life for the upliftment of the poor and needy. He was born during a time which witnessed unprecedented social, political, intellectual, artistic movement in the Bengal region of the eastern part of the Indian subcontinent. In a way, that was the transitional phase from medieval to modern Bengal. Now, after being called to the bar from the Hon’ble Society of Lincoln's in 1871, Taraknath Palit started practicing as a lawyer in this very home, though the court was established a decade ago. Now, notwithstanding the racial prejudice and discrimination prevailing at that time, within a very short span of time, he created a niche for himself. And after 14 years of him joining the Calcutta bar, the first political platform for Indians was formed in the year 1985 under the stewardship of Alan Octavian Hume. Many of the successive presidents of that organization were from this very court, right from W.C. Banerjee to Lal Mohan Ghosh to Rashbehary Ghosh to Bhupendranath Ghosh. Now, as I was researching on Sir Taraknath Palit and Sir Rashbehary Ghosh, I was wondering that almost two-thirds of early 19th century scholars, academicians and politicians were from this very court. And Taraknath Palit, Sir Taraknath Palit, was a Bhadraluk in the Sanskrit sense of the term. And of course, as has been said by Shashwat, he was a nationalist. We have also emphasized on that point. But in his brand of nationalism, there was no fusion of religion. When most of his compatriots believed in having some sectarian affiliation or the other, Taraknath Palit donated that humongous amount for the University of Calcutta and for the establishment of University College of Science and Technology. Now, I would sum up by giving you a comparative picture of Kolkata Babus of that time. Now, there were no dearth of virtuous and rich Babus in early 19th century. Right from Prince Dwarkanath Tagore to Rajan Mullik of Marble Palace fame to Motilal Seal, they all executed several trust deeds for social purposes. Motilal Seal built an almshouse at Belghoria, which fed on an average 500 people every day. He even built a Motilal Seal free college to impart education. But the point is, all this was done to counter and combat the liberal education which was being imparted by the then Hindu college, which is now of course known as the Presidency University. And that is why Taraknath Palit was unique. In 1912, when the gold rate for one tola of gold was around 19 rupees, he donated that humongous amount to develop scientific temper, humanism, spirit of inquiry and reform, which of course later was adopted in the constitution as one of the fundamental duties. Now with these words, I sum up and pay my respectful homage to his memory. Long live Sir Taraknath Palit.